This show is part of the RetroZap.com podcast network.
Hi, this is Jonas Suotamo. I play Chewbacca in the Star Wars, and you're listening to Brews and Blasters.
Dude. Here we go.
Listening to Brews and Blasters. The Star Wars party starts now.
How are we doing?
Same as always.
That bad, huh?
Pokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster at your side, kid.
Let us go inside where we can discuss business over a drink.
Could you join us for a little refreshment?
Everyone's invited, of course.
With Chris Dalton and Joe Tavano, two guys from Boston, who are talking about this stuff anyway.
Whoa.
Let him marinate with like a good steak tip.
Oh, yeah.
And Renegades. They're having a nice time.
We just got a cup of super cold. Sippy sip.
Yes. We had a barbecue.
Society.
Okay, Star Wars.
With the guy.
Dangerous.
What's up, Warheads? Welcome to the Mamma Jammer. Mamma Jammers, Triple Force Friday. Need 'em, got 'em. News. And I nearly died for a sandwich. Let's talk about it and drink some Tabasco whiskey. Shout out to all my Pittsburgh people. I was in Pittsburgh recently, and I went to Primanti Brothers, a legendary sandwich shop down in the heart of downtown Pittsburgh. And I gotta tell you, those sandwiches are delicious. I ate one right there at the counter. They put the French fries inside the sandwich.
Oh, nice.
And they have this like coleslaw and the provolone. It's delicious. It's just
all
like
right, tell me about the sandwich.
It's like a cold cut type of sandwich. Like that, you can get a bunch of different ones. So I got a prosciutto.
Is it their like signature?
Yeah, it's a signature thing. Okay. They do sandwich and they put them on the flat top, and they get the coleslaw and the French fries inside the sandwich, and it's just delicious. There's some magic in it, man. There's some magic in what they're doing.
I like both of those things.
Yeah, yeah. Even if you said you didn't, I'd be like, just go try it.
I love seashell and seashell things.
What?
I think that was from that talking lizard thing.
You're losing me right now. I gotta
you
be
know
honest.
What a king of the trees.
So I was in Pittsburgh, and all right, so I walked about a mile, and like it was like 28 days later. Monday Night Football was on, and everyone was at Heinz Field, I guess that's what it's called. And I walked a mile in the opposite direction, and I thought I was gonna die because it was like 28 days later in that town. There was no one around.
You know what's funny?
There was no one around
in Boston. When there's a Sox game or something like that,
there's still activity.
The party's in the park and outside around the park.
Yeah, exactly.
So everyone's
partying and in every bar.
They do it differently.
And then there's like, you know, millions of people who also just don't care. You know what I mean? Even during like a Patriots game, like there's still traffic. You know what I mean? Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Like we're overpopulated or something.
Yeah. Like it might be a light traffic day, but there's still going to be people on the road. You can still going to see humanity.
Yeah.
Not in Pittsburgh. Not in Pittsburgh. Not on Monday Night Football night when the Steelers are playing. 28 days later. And at the beginning of that movie, when he wakes up, hello. Mm. Like it was like that.
They made a sequel to that, right?
Yeah. 28 weeks later.
Oh, that's what it is.
That's
I knew it was something similar.
Yeah.
The zombies or something, right?
Yeah. Infected.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Biohazard stuff.
They ran.
That's what I remember. I'm like, why is everyone running? And then I remember like some kind of tunnel scene.
Yeah. So it was a little scary. It was scary getting there.
Was that a U.S. movie?
28 Days Later? No.
I was going to say, I don't think that was a U.S. movie.
It was not. And I got there. This is what it looks like, you know, like old school.
Oh,
this
okay.
is an old school type of place, you know?
It looks like old Vegas.
Yeah. And you get in, there's like a bunch of like famous people on the walls. It was empty, Chris. There was no one there. This is a famous place. You know, it was cool, the vibe there. You know, I sat right down at the counter and this is the sandwich. They put tomato and coleslaw and fries and then like your sandwich.
Let me see.
Yeah.
Let me take a look at this.
Take a look at that.
So what is that, like sourdough bread or something?
No, it's like just like fresh Italian bread.
Just thick cut?
Yeah. Nice thick cut, fresh Italian bread. It's delicious.
That looks delicious. My mouth's watering actually. That looks really nice.
I crushed it, Chris.
That's the fries, yeah. Okay.
It was so good.
Oh, heavy on the fries, dude. There's a lot of fries in that.
Chris, it was so good.
Look at the fries.
It's 2 inches
of fries.
It's
right
heavy
there.
On the fries and then you get like your meat below. And that was a prosciutto and provolone. I got a beef. Like roast beef to go. It's not like North Shore roast beef, but I got a roast beef and they do it just like this. You just shoot the meat. They just swap out the meat.
Okay. So it's still the fries, the coleslaw,
the cheese, everything's the same and you just swap out the meat. And I did that and I brought that home. Well, or to the hotel. I brought that back to the hotel and I crushed it when I got home.
I was going to say you had round two.
I got to tell you, this is the big sandwich, my friend. The big sandwich.
Did you take a picture of the steak one? The roast beef one?
No, I just smashed that right in my face.
I like your style, dude.
I know you do.
Did you have a sarsaparilla?
I did not have a sarsaparilla.
It's okay.
I'm sorry, did that get on you?
You gotta keep this.
did that get on you?
No. Well, a little bit on my arm, but if it was to fall anywhere, it fell in the perfect spot. Look, think about it. Look, I'm completely dry.
Wow. I'm not going to edit that out. I'm going to be honest. So we're already spilling whiskey here, Tabasco whiskey.
It didn't even get the show notes.
It didn't even get on the show notes. Nope. Look at that. The Chris Salton plumbing pen. Wet but unfazed.
It'll live.
It's going to smell real nice down here. It's going to smell like
Yeah, my arm will smell nice as well.
Yeah, lap it up, you know?
That smells good. What are you going to do?
Yeah, drink it, Rummy. Wow, we haven't even introduced ourselves yet.
You're so excited about the sandwich, you're literally shaking.
Yeah.
It looked like that was a salt. Do you think you could recreate that at home?
No.
No. Oh, that's
no, that's
bummer.
The thing, man.
Because I was kind of hoping like you were going to be like, hey.
There was some magic in what that girl was making. There was some magic in it, I got to tell you.
Yeah.
And like I got to that place after walking a mile through like scary streets and like The Walking Dead. And I was like, hey, do I got to be worried about anything walking back?
You know, it'd be cool if you had a horse.
I wish I did. It would have gotten me back faster. Because I got to tell you, I was kind of walking like Hulk mode. You know?
On the way back or there?
Like or both. Both, you know? Maybe not Hulk mode. It was more like
a little power walking.
I was definitely power walking. Back up, you know, eyes open.
You were like, is there any way I can get a roll of quarters?
Well, this is the thing. Do you get an extra sock?
Yeah, right.
Some doorknobs, maybe?
Yeah, you have any, like, bricks of soap?
Yeah, exactly. It was one of those. So I get there and I'm like, all right, well, I made it halfway. I got to get back. Maybe I'll Uber back if it's.
Oh, right. Yeah.
So I ask, it's an empty restaurant. And so I asked the person cooking for me. I'm like, do I gotta be worried walking around here? She's like, nah, you're fine.
Oh, it was just like one of those things.
Yeah. She's like, you're good. You know, so I'm like, oh, okay. I guess I'm okay. Maybe this is just like the rhythm of the city. You know what I mean? Like, all right, fine. Eyes still up when I walked home, walked back. I get back fine. I was unmolested the entire time.
Gotcha.
Next night, I'm riding in an Uber.
We should get you a whistle.
Probably should. Next night, I'm riding in an Uber to a different place with, you know, for another obligation. Nothing fun. But I asked the guy, I'm like, yeah. So I walked down to Parenti Brothers downtown last night. He's like, oh, you shouldn't have done that.
Oh, that's hilarious.
He's like, shouldn't have done that. They jump out at you.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm like, I didn't see anybody. He's like, exactly.
they saw you.
Oh, I'm like, what if they did? I'm pretty good, pretty aware, you know. I know my wretched hives of scum and villainy.
Mm.
I don't know, man.
They walk in single files to hide their numbers, Joe.
Dude, I don't know. I feel like the wretched hive might have scoped me out.
That's cool. It makes for a great story. I'm beyond happy that you didn't get harmed.
I'm really good. I'm really glad the sandwich was great. Because if I went through all that for like a subpar sandwich, that would have been pretty bad.
Right.
Would have been pretty bad.
The fries didn't make it dry.
No, it was delicious.
Okay, cool. All
right. Yeah, they were like, they weren't like super oily, but they weren't like dry.
Yeah, I was gonna say you need something like kind of fresh out of the fryer later onto the sandwich.
Fresh with every sandwich.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
They drop them in fresh with every sandwich.
Yeah. I like that.
All right, guys. Welcome to Brews and Blasters. That's a cold open right there. Hey, you found it. This is at the original Star Wars party. Often imitated, never duplicated, and thank you for being here. My name is Joe Tavano. Joining me, as always, my good friend, the collector's hut, Chris Salton.
Heyo.
Guys, if this is your first time hanging out with us, you're in for a mamma jamma of an episode.
Yeah, we got a lot to talk about.
We might just be rolling into a two-parter. Who knows right now? We don't know what's about to happen. All I know is I have a full sheet of stuff to talk about.
And on the back.
And we have a stack of things to open. I have a stack of action figures to open that's literally like blocking out like the light in the room.
Yeah.
It's casting shadows.
It's true.
It's wacky. And I have a bottle of Tabasco, George Dickel Tabasco Barrel Finish whiskey. I thought, I bought it on a lark. I bought it on a joke. I thought it was going to be a goof, you know, to try because I love Tabasco everything.
It's a gem.
It's delicious.
Well, that's the thing. You guys might be being like, ugh, that sounds gross. No, it's actually not. It's pretty good.
It's not.
Pretty good.
It's actually good.
I'll let you know how I feel in the morning.
Well, let me know how you feel in a couple of seconds, because I need to know when the Star Wars party begins.
Right now.
You're damn right.
Yeah, we have a lot to talk about. I can't be goofing around.
No, we're going to do it the way we do it. You know, we're just going to do it in our own style. You know, that's it. That's it.
Look, it already dried.
Look at that. What's going on with the physics of this room? It's already dry.
It just absorbed into the foundation walls.
Everything's just a little spicier in the house now. Whenever I cook, I can't. It's just all spicy. Now,
what is that? And I'm like, I have no idea.
Yeah. How is the whiskey almost gone? I don't understand.
Yeah. Good. Good combos.
Good combos. Yeah, guys, we already dropped like 2.5 hours. Yeah. I got to be honest. So. I don't know. I guess you guys are getting the end of the conversation. I don't even know how to feel about that.
I'm sure we have something left for him.
Yeah. Hey, did we ever talk about that food truck festival we went to?
I don't think so. But wait, when was that? Was that last week? That was last weekend. That's why.
It was like, no, it wasn't last weekend. It was like 2 weekends ago.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. We had a good time. We ate some stuff.
Oh, we didn't talk about it because we recorded it. Then it was that weekend.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
We had some good stuff.
I Great Cubano.
I came in swinging, gave it my all, and then I didn't.
You
eat whiffed. Anything.
I feel like you didn't eat as much as I did. I felt like I was like a pinball ball, just hitting the bumpers. Just
but
boom.
That's the way to do
bing,
it.
Bing, 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 bing. I feel like that's where I was, like just hitting it all up.
I just accepted that there was one side, and you're like, no, there's another side, and I'm like, nah, there probably is. And then you're like, hey, Chris, there's another side, and I'm like, oh man.
We would be like walking, and like everyone would be talking, and I just kind of like. Go to the bed, like, and then just like,
yeah,
like
Joe's
like,
eating a meatball.
I'm just doing a 360, and I like kind of catch up to everyone. I got food in my hand.
Yeah,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
I love how Kristen was like, my wife was like, yeah, shit, there he goes.
Yeah, I got excited for a snow cone.
The snow cone was good. You had a good snow cone.
That was a good one. Yeah, I mean, right off the bat, like I was like, all right, out of this strip of trucks, this seems to be the winner. So we ordered like chicken fingers. We ordered a Cubano, which
the Cubano was great.
The thing is, like, I like to say Cubano.
Yeah.
You know, apparently it was a Cuban sandwich, and the guy laughed at me.
Whatever.
I don't care.
Whatever.
It was still good.
It was a delicious sandwich.
But I had to wash that down with spring rolls and a taco.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it was called, like, what was it? Oh, man, I can't remember.
It was a food truck. Who cares?
The taco. It was some kind of meat. It was like drunken something.
It was like a Thai. It was like Thai meat.
Yeah, but it was like drunken.
Drunken
beef.
Chicken, probably.
Drunken beef.
Drunken
is that
beef?
A, is
okay,
that a
yeah.
thing?
Yeah, yeah. In Thai food, yeah.
It was delicious.
It was like a Thai food taco.
I liked it.
Wacky.
It was
great.
Wacky.
It's
yeah,
fusion.
Wacky. Yeah.
That's fusion. It's awesome. Yeah, I had there was a barbecue truck there. I had a mac and cheese with like barbecue like infused
into
it.
Yeah, I missed that, dude.
Oh jeez. It was just a side order. I just kind of dropped off the back of the group and just like ordered a side order quick. Caught up and I had like a full hand of mac and cheese.
I was with you most of the time. And the time that I left for like 5 minutes, you were like, "Hey, I just ate mac and cheese." I'm like, "Where is it?"
I'm like the guy. I was like the guy in what's that? It's Adam Sandler movie. Mr. Deeds. You know Mr. Deeds?
Oh, the guy with the socks.
I'm very sneaky, sir.
Yeah.
I'm like that guy. I just arrived.
The Jesus in Lebowski.
And John Turturro. He's fantastic. He really is. He's fantastic. And way sneaky.
Yeah.
When I'm at a food truck festival, man, you know, all bets are off. I am. I'm like a pinball ball. Bing, 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 bing. Just hitting it all up.
I'll bring the
That's a different one.
No, that's Mr. Deeds because he writes.
Oh
like,
yeah.
The greeting cards.
I'll bring the beers. Yeah, I like that. Oh man, where are we? We have so much to talk about. So yeah, did we talk about this? We're drinking the
Tabasco whiskey. Yeah,
it's actually good. I like that. But we have a lot to talk about tonight. We have Triple Force Friday happened. We have a lot to talk about there.
Yeah, there's a lot to cover.
We talked for like 2 hours with Jay Yakface, you know, leading up to Triple Force Friday, and that was an unbelievable show.
Yeah, and for everyone that tuned in.
A lot of people tuned in. Thank you
for tuning in, and that was a mamma jammer of a show.
That was a mamma jammer, man. I feel like we could do another 2 hours just talking about the aftermath.
Well, we did talk about possibly doing like a recap, something like that, so, whatever.
We'll catch up with Jay.
Yeah, we definitely will.
We'll do our recap tonight, and then we'll figure out what's going on, but, you know, after that, so much has happened with news, with the Rise of Skywalker, with the Mandalorian, with the Kenobi series. Star Wars Resistance is back. Jedi Fallen Order dropped another trailer. New York Comic Con happened, and Bushnikins, I guess, like there's like a ton happening with Star Wars at New York Comic Con. Like so much happened with Star Wars publishing in comics and in literature that you don't want to hear about because Journey to Star Wars, the Rise of Skywalker is happening
right now.
It's on.
Mm-hmm.
It's on. Like, come on. It's happening. As we speak, things are being released. I have books down here right now.
There's a stack of books down there.
Yeah, you want to talk about. And this is interesting canon-specific details that you're going to want to know about. Not to mention stuff like, oh, I don't know, Kevin Feige in Star Wars.
Yeah, that was so unexpected. I did not see that coming.
And, you know, some other weird stuff, you know? Not to mention your emails, voicemails, all Oppo Awards, all that. We have so much to talk about.
We're flooded.
Yeah. Yeah, so let's get to it, and let's just kick things off by talking about Howard the Duck. You ain't got the class, boy. You know what the song is, right?
Yes.
This song's good. I'm sorry.
It is good.
I don't care. I will hold this song up as one of the, like, my favorite songs of the 80s.
Hey, guess what? I really enjoyed this movie, and that's not a lie.
It's a wacky movie, but it's great.
I dig it, man.
When I was a kid, I loved it.
Yeah. I like when she touches his arm, and it's like he gets like a mohawk.
I mean,
it's cool beans, man.
We know what that is. Yeah. This is a great song. Yeah.
Is this Howard the Duck?
Yeah, I would like riding my BMX bike all around the neighborhood, like singing the song in my head. I'm like, yeah, let's go, let's do some wheelies. You know, could never do them, but whatever.
I was going to say, dude, could you pull them off?
Because
I could get the bike up and it went right back down.
No, I had no, there was no muscle on my body. It was like 7. You know? This is a great song.
It is good.
Yeah. Lucas knew what he was doing. I'm sorry.
He did.
Genius,
absolutely, and that the dude that turns into like that like weird alien creature at the end, that looks cool too.
Yeah. Hey, Tim Robbins. Hey, what if like in his treatments for like 7, 8, and 9, the end of episode 9 just ended like this?
It's just
like what if it ended with like an 80s song like this? Like, because this is how the movie ended. It just ended with them like doing a music video. He liked music. He did Jedi Rocks. Like, it would just be hilarious if the entire thing just ended with, like, a music video and everyone just starts dancing.
You know what would be funny? Like, I think me and you would be like, what? But we would end up leaving like this.
Yeah. I'd be like,
That was me jamming out.
I'd be like, good song.
Yeah. Solid.
Solid.
Closing out the saga.
I mean, yeah, like I can get behind this, you know? So, yeah.
Yeah, but you left the theater happy. I hate when movies just end. You know what I mean? Like, at least you get like a little, like, you know, show tune at the end and you're like, let's get out of here.
Yeah. So Howard the Duck is getting, you know, the soundtrack is getting a deluxe CD set.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, yeah, it's pretty cool because like there's a lot of cool music in it. This is it now. It's available for pre-order already. When MCA Records released the soundtrack on vinyl and cassette, they choose just 40 minutes of music divided roughly in half between songs and score. Oh my God, John Barry, Sylvester LeVay, and Thomas Dolby. I mean, these are like big names. Spread across three CDs, most of it being released for the first time. The product listing also adds this. In addition, the original 1986 MCA album also marks its CD premiere. Howard the Duck was created for Marvel Comics. They have blah, 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 going down here. Talking about the film itself. Yeah. So it's all stereo, including all the alternates and rewrites. Entrada was provided to access to the complete session masters of all three musical artists, including 2-inch 24-track, half-inch 3-channel, and quarter-inch 2-track stereo elements preserved in the Universal Vaults in beautiful condition.
Whoa.
What they're saying there is they went back to the original stuff that was, like, it was all recorded on.
Mm-hmm.
So to remaster that and bring it out into the set. This is, like, the definitive. They're giving us the royal treatment.
Yeah.
Like, frankly, like, I want a new set for, like, Star Wars to be done. There's been some good stuff. There's been a lot of Star Wars cinematic releases, but it would be great to have, like, another one, like really definitive for, like, the new age. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, man, yeah. There was so much going on in Howard the Duck score. So referential to other, like, great musicians of the time. You know, stuff like from, like, Bowie to, like, the Runaways to, like, George Clinton and Prince.
Yeah, you can kind of hear it all.
It was all cool. Like, this is a great song. Like, Leah Thompson singing it and, like,
this, Back
like,
to the Future, ever hear of her?
I gotta tell you, I think this is, like, I don't know if it's her best movie, but it's the one I fell in love with her on.
Oh, it was very easy to.
It was easy to fall in love
she
with her on.
She was very, like, seductive.
Yeah. You wanted to be Howard, I'll tell you that.
I do.
She fell in love with Howard?
Yeah.
You wanted to be Howard. For real.
Let's say we're all jealous of that duck.
Yeah, it's true. You know I had to do this.
You know, right when I saw the picture, I was like, this is one of those things, like, you know it's out there and it keeps coming back to bite you.
Yeah. If you guys don't know, this is actual sound from the Star Wars Holiday Special. If we could only bend this and, this is it. This is the Star Wars Holiday Special. It's not the scene. You know, Chewie's father.
Yeah,
having fun with her. But I just want to say rest in peace, Diane Carroll. She passed away.
That's terrible. I actually did not know that.
Oh, no.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
I thought you were literally just playing that because we're like, you know, playing music.
No, but, you know, she's part of the Star Wars family. She was part of the Star Wars Holiday Special. She was a very talented and, you know, very well-known, you know, performer back in the 60s and 70s. Mm. And, you know, something, you know, she has her place in Star Wars canon, Star Wars fandom.
Well, you can't take that from her. And I'll tell you, man, it's so wacky. Like,
it's so out there.
Yeah, it's real out there. Like, people are having a good time, if you know what I mean.
Probably the most provocative scene in all of Star Wars.
Yeah.
With Chewbacca's father. Like,
oh, I remember.
Watching an iPad with Diane.
An iPad before an iPad.
Yeah, exactly. He had an iPad in 1978, and he's watching Diane Carroll.
Yeah.
And she's talking to make him feel good.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's really what we're talking about there.
I just wish that I could just kind of watch people's reactions of when this aired.
I wish I was there for the first time.
You know what I mean? Like, you know? I wish it was in an auditorium and I wish I was facing the crowd and the screen was behind me because I just wanted to capture their reaction.
I was born in 1980. It just came out in 78. So I was negative two. I wasn't born yet. I wasn't even conceived.
You're thought about though.
I don't even know. I don't even know. That's debatable. But you know,
it's something debatable.
It's debatable.
No respect, I tell you.
I got plenty of respect after I was born. Trust me. Before I was born, I give him that time. Anyways, I wish I was maybe like 5-6 years old in 1978, sitting down with my family to watch the Star Wars Holiday Special. My mom and dad sitting in the back and me right in front of that TV. And like, everything just happens. You know what I mean? Everything just unfolds in front of us.
I think I would be like... They're on drugs, right? Like
I'm sure they can't say that in front of me. I'm like five, six years old, but like I'm sure my parents look at me like that.
Should he be watching this?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. What are we doing right
where's
now?
Where's Vader?
What
happened?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Why is Chewie like wrapped in a what were those things called? The blankets.
Where are the robats? Where are the robats?
Oh, Snuggies.
Yeah, where this? Why they were? But Snuggies weren't around back then.
But apparently,
why are they wearing blankets?
The Christmas special, they created iPads, Snuggies. Am I saying it right? It's the blanket you wore backwards, yeah. Basically.
Snuggie.
Yeah.
The blanket with sleeves.
Oh.
Anyways,
God.
She was a beauty, and she will have an immortal place in Star Wars fans. So rest in peace. Guys, let's talk Triple Force Friday. Did you partake? Were you part of the festivities? Were there festivities near you? There was no festivities near us. I'll tell you that much. There was nothing going on at all. Triple Force Friday was an event that wasn't an event. I don't know what happened. What happened? I don't know. I don't even know what happened. I'm like recounting in my head, and it was like, it's like if someone said, hey, come to the party, and then I just got punched in the face.
Yeah, you know
instead.
What? You know what I think happened?
Before I even got to the party, I just got punched in the face, and they said, go home.
There's no official toy store anymore, right?
All right, let me back up. Action figures aren't toys anymore.
No.
I'm going to throw that right down right now, and you're right. There is no official toy store either. So we have a disconnect in multiple areas.
It would have been a real Triple Force Friday if Toys R Us still existed. Yeah. I think what happened was this was the first Force Friday without Toys R Us. And I think Target and Walmart was like, what do you guys want from us?
Hey.
Like, that's what
remember
I got.
Remember in 2015 when everyone was open at midnight?
Dude, there was a line. There was a line.
There were lines at Walmart, at Target, at Kohl's, at Toys R Us. They were all there. There were lines everywhere. It was an event. It was a worldwide event.
Worldwide.
Yeah, people were going nuts. Now, granted, you might tell me, oh, this place is open at midnight. Yeah, it was like needle in a haystack, a couple of random places across the globe.
I think there was like 50 like places partaking in the midnight.
I could care less.
Within the United States, 50 stores is nothing.
Nothing.
We have like 5 Targets in a circle.
There was zero in the Northeast. Zero.
Yeah, nothing.
Let me tell you, guys, look it up. I don't really know numbers well, you know, doing talking and all. I got to tell you, there's a large percentage of the United States that lives in the Northeast. There were no stores that were open at midnight.
None.
Zero.
Yeah.
So
I asked for her number. She said zero.
That's true.
Mitch Hedberg.
Okay. It was a bad delivery, Mitch Hedberg. I'll tell you that. He was great, though.
He was great. Yeah. Okay, I listen to his stand-up quite often.
Me too. Mitch Altogether, killer album.
Mitch, well, you know something? I just play it on Spotify, so whatever I get, I get.
That's it.
Anyway, Triple Force
What's
Friday.
What's happening? Yeah, what would Mitch Hedberg think of Triple Force Friday?
Wow.
That's a question to really stump you.
He would think it was very hip.
It'd be good, but he had to go three times.
Right, exactly. He would do some kind of one-liner.
Yeah, that's what it would be. I went to Triple Force Friday. I couldn't get the
There was no triple, but it was Friday.
He was like, that's terrible.
Yeah, but he would do that, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, anyway.
Wow.
Why do we do this?
Wow, should we edit that out?
What? I don't know.
Anyways.
We said we're not sorry anymore, so.
I'm really not. And if you guys are, that's on you. Anyways. Yeah, so there were no midnight events. I woke up at 5 a.m. Actually, no, I woke up at 4:30. I was out the door at 5 a.m. And
I was actually confused.
Yeah.
When you were texting, I was confused. I had no idea what you were saying, where you were.
I got to the Walmart in our area that opens at 6 a.m. I got there at 5:45. You know, I got that spot right next to the door.
Gotcha. It's like handicap you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was me. I got that spot
at Target.
Yeah. Now, the sun hasn't even come up yet. The sun was a while from coming up. And I'm at Walmart. I'm like, okay, here we go. Probably not going to be anything. I was here 4 years ago and there was nothing on the shelves at this place. So let's see what's going to happen. And lo and behold, this is the largest Walmart in the region. There was nothing there. We're talking, this one's a two floor. You have to go up an escalator to get there.
Yes.
Okay. This is the type of Walmart we're talking about. There was nothing on the shelves. Frozen 2 was everywhere. Let me tell you something about Frozen 2. Frozen 2 owned Triple Force Friday.
They really did.
Yeah, Triple Force Friday was a Frozen 2 event, I think.
What Frozen had is what we had...
In 2015.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, they had their own area. They had unbelievable, like, advertising, like, signage and
all that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, that Walmart and Saugus, and you can read all this on my Twitter, too, on Triple Force Friday. Pretty salty as well. I went to a second Walmart there after that, and they told me they had stuff, and I waited for an hour in those aisles. I waited for an hour from them opening, and they said they were going to bring it out. And they brought up, to their credit, they did find a Rise of Skywalker, a very small standee. Not the big boy, but they brought out a small standee. And the second Walmart, there were lightsabers on it. There were Galaxy of Adventures figures on it. There were zero Black Series figures on it. Zero. None. And two Vintage Collection. There was a Poe and a Rey. So nothing, no new characters.
Did you pick those up?
I did. I grabbed them right there. However, it just begs to wonder, when you look at the standee that's half opened already, coming out from the back. What happened? Did maybe someone who works there, you know, raid this thing?
Absolutely. That's exactly what
it's
happened.
100% that what happened.
Like, some dude was like, oh man, this is great.
It was obvious, because, you know, they just bring it out on a pallet. It's not like, it's not like they had to put the display together. The display was already put together, shipped to them, you know, in, like, fully. And all they had to do was just take the shrink wrap off and put it on the floor. The shrink wrap was already opened before it came out. So, therefore, it's very obvious that, it had been raided before, you know, it hit the store shelves. Before anyone even knew about it.
That's so unfortunate, man.
It was very unfortunate, and it was just sad, you know what I mean? It was just not right.
I mean, the first thing that must, you know, go right through your body is rage, right?
Yeah, because I had wasted an hour.
Yeah, Rage Cage came out.
Yeah, I had wasted an hour. Yeah. This is what it looked like. You know, plenty of Galaxy Adventure. Stocked to the brim. You see that? And, like, you know, lightsabers here and there. A bunch of those motorized Dios. Oh, the commemorative collection was everywhere, too. It was at both places.
You know something?
Those gold figures, which I whiffed on. I'm not buying those.
Well, when I first saw them, I was like all in. And then I let like
a day
sink in.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't need them.
They're just spray painted repacks.
Yeah.
That's all they are. Yeah, it's very nice packaging.
It is. But
it's very nice packaging.
That's when I was like, yeah, I'm
yeah.
Like, when's enough type deal, you know?
So let's look at the standee. You can see the standee right here. You see the Galaxy's Edge. They're all packaged pretty, right? They're all packaged nice. You know, the skiff boat packaged nicely. The commemorative collection picked over. The DO picked over. The lightsabers are picked over. And then there are two spots right here for where the Black Series is supposed to be.
Totally empty.
And where the Vintage Collection is supposed to be.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No. There were two Vintage Collections sitting on the ground there.
It didn't even look like they were, like, humble of, like, removing them. It looked like they were, like,
it was a raid.
Yeah.
It was a raid.
Like, some dude was like, thank you.
Yoink. I'm just going to steal these.
Yeah.
And, so that was the second Walmart I went to. Now, granted, this is 7 p.m. I went from 7 to 8, okay? The third... Now, Target opened at 8, okay? So I was going to do 6, 7, 8, 8 p.m.
Yeah.
It's 8 p.m. by the time I leave the second Walmart. I'm like, well, in my path to get to that Target at 8 p.m., there's a third Walmart. Do I hit the third Walmart before I hit the Target? I might as well, because they're like a block apart. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That third Walmart... There's nothing. There's nothing on the shelves. There's nothing out. They didn't even. No, they've been open for an hour, and they have yet to roll anything out at all. Granted, should have been up the night before, but that didn't happen.
You know what kills me? They have people working at night.
Yeah, they
do. What were they doing?
Yeah. Well, I tell you what they're doing. I don't know what happened, but I looked at the pegs. There was one new figure. It was a Luke X-Wing, and It looked like someone had played like softball with it.
I would say
look at that figure.
Yeah, that was like UFC. Like, yeah. Somebody took their day out on that thing.
Yeah, exactly. Like
they're like, you want a figure? Wham, wham, wham,
yeah.
Wham.
Yeah, it's like they took down their punching bag and they just put this up in its place and then they decided to do it haymakers. And that's literally what it looked like. And I'm like, hey, can you mark this down at least? Like, we can give you 10% off. I'm like, this is...
Yeah, keep your dollar.
Yeah, no thank you.
Yeah, how about, like, 75% off?
Yeah, like, really?
I'm surprised the figure isn't destroyed.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Did you share that picture?
I did.
Oh, okay. I want people to see that.
Yeah. Also, in this store, Galaxy of Adventures figures were out. Packed. You know, Galaxy of Adventures are fine. They're out. In asking for the discounted price on that Smash Up figure, to the time I went back to look and see if there were anything else going on, the manager brought me back to the location. Like, yeah, we just wheeled out the display. I'm like, what? What? They wheeled up the display.
Did you go back up to this guy?
They wheeled up the display in the time I went from asking about the display, asking for the discount, and putting the figure back.
What, did he have like a walkie-talkie? He's like, bring it out, this kid here.
Maybe. Maybe that happened. So, I get back, and jackpot.
You must have been like so relieved. Were you like, oh, thank God.
This was like a triple-wide display compared to this thing. You know what I mean? It was like a whole pallet. It was like a big box of stuff with like everything on the outside. They probably had two cases, maybe three cases of every Black Series. Mind you.
Oh, wow.
No first editions.
No white boxes.
No white boxes at all. So let's back up for everyone who's not collected. They had three versions of each character in the wave. Two versions of every character in the wave. They had the first edition white box and the regular release.
Mm-hmm.
And for some of these figures, they had a carbonized figure as well. So three for some, two for all. I got the wave. I got one of the wave. And, you know, I was picking up the carbonized. Some of them were online. Some of them, between you, myself, and Bill from Dorklayer, we got all four.
We really worked very well together.
Yeah, we did. We're a unit. You know, ducks fly together.
Ducks fly together.
It's true. And I get home. I feel vindicated. I got my Vintage Collection as well. I got the whole wave of Vintage Collection. It took hours. My wife was like, where are you? I thought you were going to the gym. I'm like, oops.
You're like, I did?
I didn't get to the gym. I told, I didn't. I did not deceive. I'm like, well, new Star Wars figure on the shelves today. I had to go look, and I thought I'd be home by... I thought I'd be done by 6. I thought I'd go to the biggest Walmart at 6 a.m.
One-stop shop.
I thought that would be it.
Yeah.
I really thought I hedged my bets well. I did not. I get through the door. I get home. It's been hours now. I'm really wiped out. I get home, and the Amazon treasure truck sends me a message and says, "Hey, Hasbro First Edition Star Wars The Black Series figures 8-pack. Pick them all up together. We have the whole wave, First Edition, right here."
Yeah, when you
come pick them up.
I was like, oh, man.
I wanted to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And literally, like, when they say next day, they're not lying.
No. You pick it up at a truck, and you have it that day in
hand.
What do you
mean, pick it up at a truck?
The treasure truck is just a truck that drives around with cool stuff on it.
How do you find it?
They tell you where it is.
I never heard of this before.
It's a really wacky program, man.
Like, local?
Yeah. It was in Melrose. You could have picked up in Melrose that day. They made, like, 4 or 5 stops.
Oh, my God. And yeah. Do they, like, wait for you?
Yeah. You make an order, you pick it up between this and this time, and that's it.
That's incredible.
It's incredible.
I never heard of this.
They sold out within minutes.
Oh, okay. Then I'm glad we did what we did then.
Well, by the time I was like, I got the wave, I'm not going to buy, I'm not going to just drop this now. And you know, I also used up all my time for the day.
So Amazon got the first editions.
If I had just waited for Amazon to send me that, if I knew that was going to happen, I could have just had a nice morning. And just gone picked up all my whole wave of the treasure truck and yeah. Would have been done for the day. Who knew?
But would you get the vintage collection too? Or
no vintage collection, but I would have got the whole Black Series. Yeah. Probably fine.
I'm not gonna lie to you.
Yeah, what was your experience like that morning?
All right, so I'm really happy that I changed my plans because originally, so Walmart opens at 7, Target opens at 8.
Yeah.
Target is in the town that I work in.
Yes.
So. But I do pass the Walmart that opens at 7, going to work. But I would be passing it at like 7:30, 7:40.
Yeah,
it's too late.
I was in that store while you were passing it.
So I'm really happy. I was like, you know something? I could be a Target right when they open. Now, the day before, I went in there to scope out the situation. And that's when I saw that they had like this island display, right? And there was a couple of ladies working there, and they had their clipboard and their pens and paper. And I was like, is there going to be new product here tomorrow? And she was like, Star Wars or Frozen. And I was like, Star Wars. She's like, it'll be right here. And I'm like, all right, you know something? I'm going to come right when they open tomorrow. So I pull up about like 7:45.
Okay.
Right? So they let you in because it's a Starbucks right there, but you can't browse the store, which is really dumb.
Yeah.
Like, you shouldn't be able to check out. You know what I mean? You should be able to get in. So I wait 5 minutes. Now it's 7:50. I ask the guy. There's a guy right there. I'm like, hey, buddy, can I walk around?
And
he's like, no, you have to wait. I'm like, I'm going to wait 10 more minutes. And he's like, yeah. And I'm like, all right.
All right, guess we're waiting.
But keep in mind, I'm the only person there.
Yeah.
Now, a bunch of, you know, like old ladies filter in and out.
All
like
right,
whether they're getting their coffee. And then, of course, I ended up knowing one. And she's like, oh, I'm just here to get my medicine. And she's like, what are you doing? I'm like,
going to get my medicine, I guess.
No, I didn't lie. Like, I was like, I'm here to buy action figures that came out today.
All right,
because I don't care. I'm not ashamed. You know,
these are not. I'm sorry. The vintage collection of Black Series are not toys. Sorry.
Right.
They're not.
So
you're
so,
wrong. If you think they're toys, you're woefully misinformed these
days.
I'm
here to pick up my collectibles.
Yeah,
right.
The 2019. This is 2019. Kids are not collecting this stuff. Kids are not playing with this stuff. They don't want it. They don't care.
So what's really nice about older ladies is they don't care.
Mm-hmm.
So right when it hit 7:55, they don't care. They're walking in the store. No one's going to stop them. So I walked in with them. I had my basket, right? So the plan was we're all helping each other. Me, you, Bill, you know? So I go right to this island. I don't want to take a chance. Even though there was no other, you know, guys looking for, you know, these figures.
Oh, let me just add that three stores, zero people caring or looking for these figures.
Yeah.
Three stores in the area. No one but me caring enough to look for these figures. No one. Zero people.
At least not right when the store opened.
Chris, I was at one store for an hour. No one was looking for these figures. No one.
Two people came. One kid came in while I already took everything. Now, when I say take everything, I'm not that guy.
Yeah.
So, all right. So back to the, I get right in there. I fast walk. I do the panic fast walk.
Yeah. You know, you're trying to get there.
Yeah. But I'm trying to look like I'm just a normal dude, but I'm panicking.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. So the action figure panic walk.
Yeah. It's like power walking, but like,
yeah, exactly.
Everything's okay here. You know, so I go right there and literally one of each figure. You know something? At first, I didn't
see
them.
They had one of each figure for the Triple Force Friday event.
Yep.
So, the big merchandising event, the one that was published on StarWars.com way back in February.
The vintage that collection.
By the way, I will remind, it said midnight releases on that announcement. Remember that?
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
So when I reached this island, I think my mind was set with white boxes. So I did the quick scan, and I was like, I'm not seeing nothing.
And that Jet Trooper can really trip you up, too. That carbonized Jet Trooper is all white.
Well,
the white box.
That was on you.
It was Walmart. Yeah.
I had the Mandalorian. So I'm looking, right? And I don't know if it's just like I'm so excited and panicking at the same time. I actually didn't see anything. And then when I came to, I was like, well, the placement didn't make sense.
Okay. So they were all over the place.
On the bottom shelving, right? You saw like all those Galaxies of Adventure and stuff like that. And then on the right side, it was one of every figure. So I literally, I bought them all.
Yeah.
You know, because it was the complete wave.
Because they only had one wave. They only had one figure for each. They only had one unit for each character.
Now, usually in a case, there's doubles of at least one or two characters. There was one of every character.
Yeah.
Right?
So it's ridiculous. Maybe it got broken up between two stores. Who knows?
I have no. Well, what I was thinking, I was like,
oh, the white boxes went some. Maybe those white boxes in regular in one case.
Possibly. But
and
I
someone
was
picked
thinking,
up all the white boxes.
I was like, oh, they're probably in the toy section. That's what I was thinking
maybe.
At that time. So on the bottom right, that's where the Black Series were. On the top left, that's when I was like, oh my God, the Mandalorian's right there, the carbonized one.
Yeah.
There was five of them. Oh. So, you know, I like. Joe, Bill, you know, so I took three and then I start looking at the vintage collection. They had doubles of like Luke X-Wing. I think there was two Jet Troopers, Sith Jet Troopers.
Yeah.
But I'm not a completist. I got like the Sith Jet Trooper. I got the Knight of Ren. I got Zori Bliss, beautiful figure, by the way. Killer figure.
Mm-hmm.
I love the Egyptian bounty hunter look, whatever that is. I really dig
it. We're gonna open them up and take a look.
Very petite. I really like it.
Yeah.
And then there was another one. Ray.
Yeah.
And Ray.
Great Ray figure, by the way.
Great Ray. There was a great Poe figure, but I passed because I knew I won't have a trouble with that picking it up later on.
Not at all. Yeah.
And there was X-Wing Luke, which was already released in the 3-pack.
Mm-hmm.
So now that I secured the acquisitions, right, I was like, all right, let me go to the toy section, see if these white boxes exist. Joe, nothing.
Nothing.
There was nothing in the toy section.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Right. So this is all they got. Now, at this time, I did a follow back. Right. I was like, let me see. And then I saw the Black Series mystery box.
OK. Yeah. So the mystery box, what was this? It was just a blind box of stuff.
It's a blind
box.
Like
a loot crate.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right.
And they have a figure in it.
And I'm very happy I didn't like get suckered into that. I looked at it.
Yeah.
I looked at it.
How much was it?
40.
$40 for a blind box.
You get a figure, a hat, a shirt, and a pin.
OK.
It's a pretty good deal, but
not bad.
These boxes, what I noticed because I watched a ton of YouTube reviews, they're all the same.
Yeah.
So it's the Snowtrooper with that white cape. That's
okay.
What you're getting. There's no surprise now. It shouldn't even be called the mystery box.
Yeah.
That's what's in it. But at that point, that's when I saw, you know, another dude. He had one of the carbonized Mandalorians.
Okay.
And he was like...
So someone else was coming in.
Yeah, he was scouting around in like... I had my basket filled with stuff and I had like two figures in my hand because the basket didn't hold that.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, man, I hope this kid doesn't think like I'm one of those jerks that are going to put this all on eBay, because I did not actually put one thing on eBay. Those were all for us.
Nice.
You know?
Yeah.
Because that's how we roll. And and then I'm checking out. I check out. I get to my car and a car pulls up. This dude gets out. He's wearing a Boba Fett hoodie and he actually runs into the store.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, dude, like, I understand, like, if you had something going on in your life and you couldn't be there when they opened, but I'm really happy that there you go.
Yeah, you can buy the actual collector's box Snowtrooper for $40.
Or you could just buy the box for $40 and get all the other stuff and actually wear it. Winter's coming up. You have a winter hat. The only thing with the t-shirt,
I wonder if
like,
you can find it still.
Oh, I'm sure. Dude, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Actually, I haven't been in a Target ever since, but, you know, I'm sure.
You know, interesting. Yeah, I haven't been to Target yet either.
Yeah.
Curious.
Well, I shouldn't say that because I went to the Target near your house.
Yeah.
And they had no clue of what was going on.
Okay.
Let's put it this way. When they're already out of stock,
yeah.
The lady was putting up the display. So I was like, what's
the point?
Like, what are you putting in the display?
Well, they're probably going to get... A lot of these places are getting inventory later.
Yeah.
Like, they kept on telling me that. And I'm like, well, what's the point of A, not selling it before October 4th, and B, having an event marketed for October 4th?
Right.
What was the point of that? What was the point of making me get up to go to this place on October 4th if nothing's going to be in and you're expecting inventory later?
Right.
It was disgusting. It's a disgusting joke.
Right.
You know what I mean? And it's just funny to see, like, in 2019... I didn't encounter anyone else looking for this stuff. You encountered two people.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you, the reports I've received from many people out there in the world, across the board, very similar. Very, very similar.
We actually covered four Targets because I'm trying to find that Jumbo Boba Fett Funko Pop Target exclusive for Roy from the UK.
Oh, yeah. UK toy collector?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I want to do right by him, and I'm trying to find it.
Good guy.
And I've been striking out. And you know what kills me? Like, people all over, they've been taking pictures of, like, the displays.
Yeah.
And they're finding it. Dude, we're not getting it around here.
No, we're not.
I'm sure
it's tough.
It might pop up.
Yeah.
But it didn't stop there. You know, I did work.
Yeah.
You know, but yeah, I did work. You know, that was my coffee run.
It was.
You know, and on my lunch run, I went to GameStop.
Oh, let's talk about GameStop because, you know, surprise, there was a special figure at GameStop that they didn't really tell anyone on Triple Force Friday. The official checklist.
Yes. No, didn't make it on there.
Didn't make it on there, but something that wasn't even out on Triple Force Friday did, that ATSD Raider. Which is out, like, in November from Best Buy.
Best Buy, yeah.
Yeah, but it's in November. It's not even out on October 4th.
So I don't know why it would be on the checklist.
Yeah,
for exactly. Triple Force, right?
Exactly. So, yeah. Anyways.
So
Commander Fox, Clone Commander Fox, Black Series, GameStop exclusive, available there on Triple Force Friday, not even marketed or promoted at all.
I actually didn't tell you about this.
Okay, tell me.
When I went to the one near Revere.
The Chelsea one?
The Chelsea one, right?
Okay.
So that's where I got the carbonized second sister, right?
Mm.
Now, I bought it. They were putting them on the shelf, right? So I got lucky. I picked one of those up. They did not have Commander Fox. I purchased this. I'm walking to the car. I never seen this. This is the first time this happened to me. I'm walking to my car, and I'm looking at the figure, and I'm like, her leg's on backwards.
Really?
The leg was on backwards.
No kidding.
So I ran back in there. I'm like, dude, please tell me you have another one of these.
Yeah.
And he's like, why? I'm like, look at the leg. And he was like, what? And I'm like, you might want to, like, send this back.
Yeah.
Dude, it was backwards.
That's ridiculous.
No, it wasn't turned backwards.
They manufactured it backwards.
Yeah, like... All right. Picture the...
It was just the joint was done wrong.
Yes.
They put the bottom half of the joint in wrong.
The upper portion was on correctly. The bottom was...
Yeah.
It's
like
backwards.
It's like if you took your leg off at the knee...
And spun it around.
Then you spun it around and put it back into your knee joint.
Yeah. So thank God he had another one. So I was like, all right, well, total success, you know?
It'd be kind of gruesome to do that, but whatever.
Because at that point, like, now we locked in all the carbonized, the four. Because in the morning, we all work together, like
I
said.
I ordered my second sister on Amazon.
GameStop.com.
It might have been GameStop. Yeah.
There was a lot of different links flying around. Like, the group text we had was very helpful.
Yeah, I got the carbonized Sith Trooper on Amazon at, like, 5 a.m.
Yeah, that was, like, first thing. Like, we opened our eyes and was like, okay, what's available?
Yeah, exactly. Sith Trooper available on Amazon.
You know what was great? You know we're all, like, freaking out because at one point I said something was available and you just wrote back, links.
No punctuation, no capital, just link.
Yeah, and that's when I got it. Like, I didn't even respond. I responded with a link. Like, yeah. I wasn't like, okay. I was just like, here's the link.
I'm sitting at the Walmart waiting for it to open in the dark, wondering if I'm going to get breakfast.
Yeah.
And I'm like, where's the link?
That's like, one of those things, like, you would have put
I'm like,
my...
I'm like, what is this kid doing?
You would have just super punched my phone at that point.
I'm like, he's like, yeah, it's up. I'm like, where?
In my defense, I was like 8 minutes, like, freshly up in the morning. And I'm I think it's up.
We're all zombies.
You're like, link. Yeah, we went nuts.
You got me in that one.
But what was crazy is it just seemed like we were the only people.
The only ones.
I don't hate it. I like it. We were able to shop like gentlemen. It's not, you know something?
The part about shopping like gentlemen is, in the end, you go to a store and it's an easy purchase and you leave feeling like a gentleman, not like trash.
Yeah.
Who has to walk into a children's aisle to buy things that kids don't want.
That's why I didn't mind there being an island.
Yeah, that's true.
I was like, thanks for putting this up for me.
Yeah, we actually didn't go. I had to walk to the children's aisle to find nothing there.
Mm.
But yeah, it is true. These were not marketed to children. I will say that. They were next to the Galaxy of Adventures, which is for children. Those are the toys now.
Those are the toys now. This is actually, like, I don't know if I feel weird saying this, but this is like big boy stuff. You know what I mean?
It's not marketed to children. The vintage collection is not for children. It's the vintage collection for people who remember the vintage age.
True.
It is the only line, too. There is no Rise of Skywalker toy line.
I'm sure it's far and few, but speaking for myself... if I was 12 years old, like 11, 12, like I'd be all about, I would be like, this is for me.
Yeah, but that's because we came from the action figure era.
Yeah, this is true.
No one cares about this stuff anymore.
Dude, everybody was home playing video games. So I don't know what they do. I don't know what they're doing
something. All I know is that there were no kids stuff. No one cares.
It was me and some old lady looking for her medicine for her, tooth or something, she was doing.
And I know what a lot of you might be thinking out there, thinking like, oh yeah, my kids play with Star Wars toys all the time. That's because you're a Star Wars fan. You're giving it to them.
Yeah.
Or they're getting it through. They're getting the fandom through you, and now they're fans too. Kids who don't have adults as Star Wars fans in their lives are probably not getting that same sort of fervor for action figures. Mm-hmm. They may still love Star Wars, but the connection to Star Wars through action figures is not there.
Right.
Unless it's, like, taught to them, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
From an older generation.
So, it didn't stop there, because you picked up the carbonized Jet Trooper, and I had mm-hmm. the carbonized Mandalorian, so I was like, you know something? I want it now.
Yeah,
I want
it now.
Yeah, yeah. So I was like, Joe, I'm coming to your house.
I'm coming to you. Yeah, you did. So, you came to the house.
So we came, we chatted for a little bit.
We chatted.
We swapped figures.
Yeah, it was great.
And then I was like, you know something? I'm going to check the GameStop on 114.
Went down to 114. Yeah, okay.
So I got lucky. There was one Commander Fox, and I was totally surprised. I wasn't expecting that, but I was just like, you know, something. Let me take a shot. It's like in my neighborhood, you know.
Yeah.
And I got lucky.
Not really, but yeah.
Well, from your house to there, it's a hike. From my house to there, I cut through. I do the back roads like I get home pretty fast
nice,
from there.
Nice, good.
And Alexa found a really good shortcut through the neighborhood.
Oh, tell me after the show. Yeah, I want to find that
dude,
one out.
It's fast.
I think I know what you might be doing, but it's...
Because we take that when, even though he got... Well, we'll get him another haircut before we go to Florida.
Do you go by Capone's restaurant to get to this?
Yeah, you have to go by Capone's. There's no highway. There's no highway.
I know where you're going.
You go residential.
I know where we're talking.
And then it just spits you right out.
Yeah. Anyways, so the next day, I had some time to myself.
Dude, okay, so now we're talking about Saturday.
We're talking about Saturday. All right. Talking about Triple Force Saturday.
Okay, Triple Force Saturday.
And I say, okay, I'm going to go look for this Commander Fox. Okay? It might be a fool's errand because people might be scooping these Commander Fox up. And I also heard that, like, if you didn't pre-order it, it may not be shipped to the store.
I didn't even know you could pre-order this.
Yeah, I know. But I heard a lot of stuff after the fact.
They told me three per store. and there was only that one.
That's not true.
Oh, see, you see what I mean, though? Yeah.
So I go to the Salem GameStop.
His buddy must work at Walmart.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I go to the Salem GameStop, okay? Coincidentally, right next to the Walmart. And I walk in there.
That's the Walmart you got lucky with?
Yeah.
You should have went to GameStop.
I didn't know at the time.
Oh, they open at like 10.
Yeah, that's the truth. That's the truth. And I also didn't know at the time that Fox was like going to be available that day.
I didn't know either.
Okay, so I walk in there and I get a couple of really smarmy dudes, you know, really happy to tell you that they don't have it. They sold out. You know what I mean? You ever run into those salespeople?
Oh, yeah. You want to know why? That's because they bought it for themselves and it's in the back.
Yeah. So I get one kid who's like, hey, man, how can I help you? I'm like, oh, looking for the new Star Wars Black series that was released yesterday. Clone Commander Fox is like, oh, okay, let me check it out. And then it's like, probably his boss was like, yeah, we sold out yesterday. We had two, we sold them. And he's like smiling as he's telling me. I'm like, okay, cool. This guy's looking at different stores right now to tell me like where it might be.
Oh, so what?
What's happened? My phone's talking to me right now. I don't know what just happened.
So one out of the two guys actually wanted to help you.
Okay. Yeah, so one guy's nice and one guy's just be like, it's sold out. Sorry. And I'm like, yeah, I'm just going to wait for him to look it up at a different, see if what the inventory is around at different stores. He's like, yeah, it's going to take a while. I'm like, yeah, I'll wait.
Yeah,
I'm like, I waited at a Walmart for an hour yesterday, so
yeah,
I got time. I'll figure this one out. And he tells me there's five at one store. And two at another.
Locally?
Yeah. There was one. It was in Lynn and in Danvers.
Where is there a GameStop in Lynn?
Right down the center. When no one goes.
Oh, over here? Near like Wyoming Square?
No.
Like down there?
No, no. I'm talking Lynn Center. I'm talking downtown.
I'm totally drawing a blank, man.
You probably don't go there. That's why.
Like Weston Ave?
Yeah. I'm talking where Shaw's was.
Yeah, you don't go there.
You don't go there. No one.
It's going to make Pittsburgh look like
it was very, very similar. I'll tell you. Very similar vibe. But I know what I'm getting into over there.
You said there was, what, one or two?
There were two.
Oh, go with the five. Where was there five?
The five was at the one you went to the day before.
Oh, 114.
Yeah. Somehow they got five more in.
Okay.
Okay.
Good.
Good to know. So
the best. The best employees right there.
So
he probably saw three and was like, we got three. Everyone got three.
Exactly. So the Lynn one was,
I'm sorry if you guys work at GameStop. Hopefully, you know.
We're not sorry no more, Chris.
Oh, that's true. Oh.
All right.
Well,
so
stop hiding figures, guys.
Stop stealing them. Stop buying them before they're out. Stop. Just stop. Just let us buy the figures.
One of you guys have to work at GameStop, and we're coming for
Integrity.
You.
Integrity. Integrity. Have to. Anyways, the Lynn one was closer. So I'm like, all right, they got two there. They've had two for 24 hours. I might as well just head over there.
Can you call and say, hold it?
Nah, I just shot right over there.
Oh, I would have been like, call them now.
It was a 10-minute drive, all right?
Yeah, but sometimes the computer says two.
All right, well, I'm going to find that one. I'm like, all right, so if that's the case, I'll just go to where the inventory's five.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? We'll figure this one out. I get down to the Lynn Walmart down in the center. And
brass knuckles. City of Sin.
It's true. The nickname of Lynn is Lynn, the City of Sin. You don't come out the way you came in.
You don't.
That's the actual like motto. Anyways, I walk in and Carbonized Second Sisters are sitting right on the counter, right behind the.
Did they have a lot of them?
They had a couple. Yeah, they had Carbonized Second Sisters. They had Commander Foxes.
Right when you walked in, so you saw it.
Yeah, I saw
it
right there.
You must have been like, oh, thank God.
And I'm like, hey man, looking for it. And he's like, boom, right here. And the guys were cool. He's like, here you go.
He's like, we knew you were coming.
Yeah. And I was like, do I buy, does Bill need one? Because Bill was also on a GameStop hunt looking for a second sister. So I was.
I didn't know that. I didn't know he was looking for the carbonized.
Oh,
one.
He would text him throughout the day. You must have been busy. You must have been jammed up.
As far as the second sister carbonized went, I honestly thought both of you ordered it through the link. I'm honest to God. I thought you guys were covered.
No. We were looking. So I was. I ended up.
You didn't order it online.
I ended up ordering online.
See, that I could have sworn I saw.
But Bill was looking for it. Okay, so they had him there. So I asked him if he needed it, you know, or if he needed a Fox. And I'm like, no. But I actually, like, the guy, like, handed me two because he thought I might buy two because Bill might be looking for one. I'm like, well, can you give me the, he's not going to get it because he got it on his own. Can you hand me the nicer one? He's like, I get it, dude. I'm a collector.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I'm like, cool, you know. Because at this point, I don't know if I'm taking them out of the package or not. I don't know what's going on.
Mm.
We'll get to that later.
That one might, you know, that one might go up in price only because, like, look what happened with the Shock Trooper. Like, that one holds about, like, a $50, $60 price range. That's being re-released.
It's being re-released.
Exactly.
So that's not going to hold value at all.
No.
I ripped that thing open years ago.
Unless the package is different because it had a sweet, like, reflective, like, image.
Bro, they're not. I gotta tell you, looking for that Shock Trooper was a difficult time.
I think I got it on eBay.
I got it at Walmart, and it was like, I had to. They found one in the back, like, hidden. You know, that was a weird one. But I ripped that baby open. That's a great figure. Great stiff mechanical joints.
The Shock Trooper?
Yeah.
Now, I'm not going to lie to you.
Great posability, too.
And I know that I said, like, 10 minutes ago that, you know, I don't buy things to sell them. I did sell my Shock Trooper.
That's too bad. It's a great figure.
But, I got $60 for him.
Okay.
Right, but...
Now buy it again for $20.
That's what I'm going to do.
Who's naked? So, you just made $40.
Well, right... Yeah. Did I... No. Money comes and money goes real fast.
I feel like that might be the episode title. You just made $40, did I?
Yeah, right, exactly.
Anyways, let me finish up here with the GameStop story. I got my Commander Fox. I talked to some collectors. The guy, I could have bought a bunch more second sisters.
So there was a lot, huh?
But then there was a white box there.
Oh,
there was a first edition there.
It's cool. It's cool to see one out in the wild.
And
I didn't see any.
And I'm like, hey, I'll take that first edition Kylo Ren.
Now, were you able to get Kylo Ren on the regular black box too?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I got him right over there.
You can always return it though, you know.
But here's the thing. Here's the thing, Chris. What do you do? You buy the white box, the first edition, as a collector's item to keep it mint, right? You want that minty fresh because you believe it's gonna be a valuable thing.
No, I actually just wanted one of the white box, and I just kind of wanted to just keep it just to be like, because they might never do that again. And
they
wanted to be like, you know, I lived through this.
Yeah,
you know?
because now I have it. You know what I mean? Now I have that. I'll put that in the sleeve
just
and that'll
one,
be it.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's cool. So that's what I have. And I'll open up my regular edition and that'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's kind of like where we're at.
I think as far as them sending things out, there shouldn't have been any black boxes on the shelves. It should have been white boxes
for
Triple Force Friday first release. So we got the second release.
You know what's funny? It should have been white boxes. And I got to be honest with you, Chris. Whatever wasn't sold on October 4th, send it back to Hasbro. Let them take it out of the package and burn those white boxes.
Back in the day, that's probably what would have happened.
It would have happened. And you only got those white boxes on October 4th. And for forevermore, it was all black boxes.
Throw us a free t-shirt, too. I mean, well, come on.
Yeah, I know. Hey, remember on Triple Force Ride, we used to get posters?
Posters, t-shirts. We got both. We got posters and t-shirts.
It was an event. It was an event people cared about.
No, remember, like, Toys R Us, they came out, and they're like, hey, listen, we don't have the t-shirts, but we're going to write down your name and phone number and size, and we'll call you.
I never got that t-shirt.
No, I did. They called me.
They never called me.
Well, I mean, it was kind of like a whatever tee. It was like one of those Funko Pop.
Oh,
like,
yeah. Oh, wait, maybe
shirts.
Maybe I did and I threw it away.
Yeah. I probably have it. I don't know where it is.
But I'm going to tell you right now, I'm sick. Funko Pops are a disgust. They make me sick.
I could care less about those things, but I'm going to admit something.
I like that they do characters.
No. This is what I'm going to...
I like that
you're going to be right there with me. Now, if they do, you know how sometimes they do like
a blurg? If they do Funko Pop.
See, this is why we're buddies.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
you read my mind.
I know, I read.
Because that's the only way I will give them my money. Besides for that, I'm not buying nothing.
It's true. It's true. I gotta tell you, I think they did Bill and Ted ones, and I'm like,
Oh, did they really?
I think they did, and I'm like,
they did a Post Malone. Pretty cool.
Who? What's that? What's a Post Malone?
Post Malone.
Like
he's a.
Does he like deliver stuff?
He's an artist, like a singer.
I gotta tell you,
songwriter.
One last thing with Triple Force Friday. Someone said it best on Twitter. It's called Triple Force Friday because you have to force the salespeople to bring out the product.
This is true.
It's not really an event. It was a mess.
It you know something. It was a mess.
I hope it's the last one. I got to be honest, Chris. I hope it's the last.
I just quote unquote like,
Force Friday.
I don't like doing that to my heart rate. You know, like can we make an event? It's just called Shop Like Gentlemen. Like just get a bunch of stuff. It'll sell. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. If you can't actually get the stores to bring out your damn product from the back, don't have the event. It was embarrassing.
Or either that.
It was I felt embarrassed. Everyone else felt embarrassed. The store owners felt embarrassed. Everyone was embarrassed. It was a weird thing that happened.
But there's always people that work at a store that know something about a section.
Yeah.
Right. Like, you know, this is what I would do if I was a manager of a Target. Right. I would be like this. Who likes Star Wars? Who's like with it? Okay. Mm. These four guys. I need you full force. For a couple of days right there. I'm not going to get the lady from cosmetics.
Mm-hmm.
And she's going to be like, I don't know. And I'm like, well, why are you here?
Yeah, if I was the store manager, I understood that this was going to be an event. You know, you check the inventory the day you check in the inventory. And then you check it like, you know, every week.
Mm.
Make sure nothing's dropping off. Make sure nothing's falling off the back of the truck.
You know, very true.
Well, as we approach October 4th, because that happened.
No.
That happened a lot.
The first thing that I thought of when you said you struck out at a couple of Walmarts, Walmart is notorious for putting stuff out before and then it just sells, and that's why they have no inventory.
Yeah, but that didn't happen.
Because I'm not going to lie to you, I got a couple of Rogue One 2 packs way before the Rogue Friday happened.
But that was a lesson learned back that day. They buttoned up their things, their policies after that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in any event, Triple Force Friday. Hope it's the last one. And I want more figures.
Oh, they're coming. They're
but,
coming.
I do. Yeah, we'll get to New York Comic Con.
More exclusive than ever right
more,
now.
Yeah. I mean, they're it's essentially a subsidy for a figure. You're getting a company to pay to make a figure for them. That's what you're doing. It's basically like instead of crowdfunding, it's corporate funding.
Yeah.
You're corporate funding a figure to have it exclusive in that store.
So that's how that works?
Yeah. Yeah.
So, all right.
Hasbro's like, hey, you know, do you want to sell an exclusive figure? Okay, give us this money, and we'll make this figure exclusive for you.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. So, for instance, Best Buy with the IG-11, right? So they're like, hey, we want in on this. And let's just say Hasbro's like, okay.
But yeah, it might go the other way around. Hasbro might say, hey, we can make a figure for you.
But let's just say we need $8,000. You're going to get this many cases and that's that.
Yeah, it's probably more than $8,000, but yes.
But you know what I mean.
Exactly. Right? Yeah. Well, theoretically.
One store, $8,000.
Theoretically. Yeah, exactly. Like we'll give you $1 million. You get, you know, 1 million figures. Something like that. Who knows?
Dude, they're so smart. Like, you got to give it to Hasbro.
Yeah.
And I'm not, dude, not for nothing. These figures.
But that's why. Exclusives proliferate because that's how they're funding it. It's a cheap way of making figures.
The figures are getting better and the prices are staying the same for the most part.
For the most part,
For the most part. Like carbonized, extra $5 for some premium paint. Cool. You got my $5.
You want to take a look at these figures now?
I do.
Let's do it. All right, guys, this is going to wrap up part one of our epic Need 'em, Got 'em for Triple Force Friday. And be sure to check in the next few days, next week, for part two, where we keep on opening up even more figures and talk about everything that happened at New York Comic Con as well. So keep posted for that because we have a lot of thoughts. And a lot more figures to open, too. What's going to happen in the Vintage Collection? It's going to happen with the Tabasco Whiskey. I don't know. But, yeah, we'll see you guys next week.